Hello everyone and welcome back to the channel and another segment of Why You Telling My Business? Don't be telling my business. Well, I can and I will. Okay? Sorry about that, guys. Y'all know I'm still under the weather. But I'm still trying to crank them out for y'all. Well, this story is about Big Tigger, the morning show host of V103. Urban radio here down in Atlanta, Georgia. Yes, y'all know he had some more shows that he was in California hosting, I think, Tigger in the Basement, whatever. But anyway, he had to come back to Atlanta, get his notoriety back, and he's flowing real well. But anyway, I said it to say this. He had two guest hosts that start co-hosting with him starting in the new year on January 3rd, 2022, and her name is Miss Pat, right? Miss Pat Wiz. I gave y'all her resume on one of my other videos before this one, but in case you don't know, we just gonna say she's a comedian. And really, I'm comparing her to Wanda.
I can't remember Wanda's last name, but she was here for almost 20 plus years in Atlanta, being a radio host with Frank Ski Morning Show, and everybody should know Frank Ski Morning Show. They know anything about Atlanta and V103. But anyway, kind of comparing her to Wanda because she's not funny. Pat's not funny. She's supposed to be a comedian, but she just don't make me chuckle, ha ha, laugh. Okay. But anyway, this is a good case for Dennis McKinley. Hopefully, he listens to V103 because you know he's fairly young. And he has many restaurants that caters to the younger group. And they could be definitely telling him, putting some, you know, words in his ears to drop down in them streets. And definitely see if he can get some time on V103 to do a rebuttal on Miss Pat. And asking why she thinks she gonna put paws on his mama. Because she was on the show. You know, Shamia was also another guest host or co-host of the Big Tigger Morning Show that runs between the hours of 6 a.m. to 10, I believe. And they up there, you know, sporting themselves. And they had Portia on for a little feature segment talking about her show and how it's faring and all this kind of stuff. And Portia wasn't making no sense. Ain't no sense even going on into what she was saying because it wasn't worth the air that she breathed out to make a formulation of a answer to that response on how she feel her show was going. Okay, but Pat was like all in arms way, talking about, oh, you want me to slap Miss Gina for you? Because I slapped grandparents. I slapped, I don't know if she said grandparents or she slapped grandmas. I have no idea. But to me, that was not a funny joke. That was somebody I wouldn't even put in my repertoire of trying to slap Big Mama. You know what I'm saying? That's a quick way to the graveyard or the hospital. Quick way to the graveyard or the hospital. You talking about slapping Big Mama? No, ma'am. No, 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 no. But she kind of seemed like it wasn't a joke. Like she'll go do work on her. She do stuff like that and all that kind of stuff. And I'm like, Portia, why would you sit up here? It's supposed to be about you and your show, you moving, you giving your house to your mom as an asset because you don't want to lose it. We know what the real tea is. You ain't gave your mama that house, honey. She just living in it as a guest until you could figure out how to get out of this mess with Simon talking about y'all finna get married. When we know that's father from the truth. There's no love there. There's nothing there but dead space. But anyway, this woman sat up there and told you she'll take care of your mother-in-law for you. She'll do the do work on her. She will put paws on your daughter's grandmother, your ex-baby daddy whom you confess to love and this, that, and third. And you have so much anger towards him that you would let another woman that don't even know you like that would fix her mouth to have those words come out her mouth saying that she gonna do harm, bodily harm, to your daughter's granddaughter. This lady named Pat. I'm telling y'all,
ain't gonna say go boycott nobody or just, you know, turn a sour out of her. And Rick Cafferty, it's your listener, baby. You're supposed to be the producer, the manager up there at V103. Is this what you got going on? You know, because it seemed like it'd be another little Wanda situation going on. I mean, do we need Pat, husband, boyfriend to come up there, show up and show out, cuspo out to get rid of this Miss Pat who talking about doing bodily harm to another person? See, that won't listen to V103 no more. Rick Cafferty just have too much stuff going on at the V103 to be disrespecting folks, and that was a sign of violence right there that Dennis definitely should be, you know, making notes, her and Miss Gina as well. And with Portia being in that vicinity, in that earshot, in that conversation, and she did not defend her daughter's grandmother from being violated in any way, shape, or form while she's in the presence of it, you know, I don't know what to say. It's not that wouldn't be a, if I was a judge and somebody brought that to me on audio, or I could go back and research it and it plays back that you were in the witness of someone trying to say they'll do harm to someone that you called yourself loving at one time and happens to be the grandmother of your child, and you condone that whole conversation as co-signing that, yeah, go ahead, do what you gotta do. You know what I'm saying? She should have kept her mouth shut. You know, I don't understand that. And I really don't understand if Bravo would want you to come back in any capacity condoning that stuff. Because I'm like, didn't they send you to anger management? Because on that last show that was aired, episode on Portia's Family Matters, episode 5, season 1, you tried to put pause. You were swinging on your baby's daddy. And then you want to hook up with somebody that said they want to do work, physical harm to your baby's daddy's mother? I'm like, with people you call yourselves friends with, Shamia, and she blasting out your address. Well, she didn't give she gave the area, which was Sandy Springs. She didn't give you the, she didn't give us, the viewers, your address or anything. But I mean, anybody in Atlanta can put two and two together, go up there and pull up your house, they'll find it. But I'm just saying, it's probably in a gated community as well. So they really wouldn't get too far unless they bribe somebody for some money or something like that. And they, you know how they go, all right? But for you to sit up there and condone someone that's wanting to do harm to someone that I know your daughter loves, that's pretty piss poor parenting and need to be evaluated lawfully, seriously. Because if anything came up to Mama Gina or about Mama Gina in the press, who do you think they're going to come look for, Portia? Well, first they're going to go look for that Miss Pat. But then they gonna look for you because you may have done it for hire. You see what I'm saying? Where I'm going with this, Portia? Do you see what I'm saying? Do you see where I'm going with it? But see, if you had a mother that was really in tune with what you're doing as far as a career choice, you really wouldn't be in this situation. You know what I'm saying? Because you had to go back on V103 the next day, do a rebuttal, and say, no, Miss Pat, you're not going to touch. Don't even joke about, don't even hint at anything negative towards my daughter's grandmother, Gina. Don't do it. It's not acceptable. And I was wrong for not telling you that when we were having the interview that morning or yesterday morning. See, that's how powerful that situation would have went between a mother and a daughter, and getting that daughter straight on what she did was pretty foul. Pretty foul. Because I promise you, if Dennis would have went on the show and he said anything about your mama or somebody wanting to do something to your mama, and he was essentially co-signing it by not defending your mother's honor, even though she may have said, done some things that were questionable that you didn't like,
but you still did not take up for her and you wanted somebody to do work on her, Portia would have had probably cops at your door with tape recordings of what was said, how it was said on the morning show. So, you know, y'all can sit here and take up for Portia. Y'all can say she this, that, and the third. She a good person. This is entertainment. When does truth come in, reality come in, and it not be for entertainment? Because you can't have entertainment one day and say, oh no, this is my life, the next day. No, you can't have it. And this is Portia's real life she's living out here. Ain't no fakeness in here. You may get a little scriptedness, but you got a whole lot of Portia and her evil ways. And like I said, it's just spewing out. And you know what was a fan favorite at one time? She's showing her true colors, y'all. Because she done bit out more than she can chew. And she got to keep looking for sensational stories to become her. Because that's what she thinks people want. But it's not even about us. It's about, you know, Portia living her best life. Her best honorable life. Free of so much sexism all the time. I mean, it would be nice and refreshing to see her with clothes on. They make clothes for you to still see a person's feature or their silhouette of their feature and what could possibly be under those garments. You know, less, she feels less is more. Well, we're saying no, baby. More is less, okay? Because you need to clean up your image. Because right now, you have no image of you that anybody in their right mind, young ladies in their right mind, want to follow. Unless they want to follow the same bridge you got yourself into when you were having all those suicidal thoughts at a very young age. High school, middle age. And you want to be a role model. And you want your daughter to have aspirations such as yourself. I mean, come on now. Come on, pull up, okay? Pull up if it ain't nothing but setting the standard for your daughter going forward. But that was just piss poor judgment. And I really hope this year Dennis gets some orders in place to not only protect his daughter, but for his mother and himself too. He needs some protective orders in place ASAP. Because Portia teaming up with these two people, and the shit gonna hit Shamil in the face too if she keep hanging around Portia and dealings with Portia. And I'm sure if her husband is an upstanding type guy that don't want to be put in a fishbowl, he's gonna have some words with his wife Shamil. And it's gonna more likely be, we need to end this friendship. Because it's coming to be too toxic, and I don't want my daughter or you to be caught in the crossfire, because that's gonna bring me in the picture, and I didn't want to be a part of this mess in the beginning. So if Shamil don't get her act together, she ain't gonna have no husband, because her husband gonna get to walking. He gonna get to walking and talking to somebody else that's gonna make a wife for him the way he wanted it to be from the beginning. He's giving her enough rope to hang herself. But I hope Shamil don't fall into the trap of trying to follow her friend Miss Portia. Because Portia has no life left in her. It's only darkness. And that's between her and the Lord that can bring, well, the Lord and her to bring her back to some type of happiness, some type of legacy that she wants to be proud of, okay? Because she definitely done destroyed that Jose Williams thing. We already know from this show that she gave us a 5 episodes pending another one coming, that Williams side, what is Portia's mother's real name? Drop the Williams, because that was her married name. But what was Diane's maiden name is what I want to know. Because that's the energy that Portia is finessing herself under. It ain't the Williams industry or name say, that's Portia's mama's maiden name. And I might have to research it myself and come back with a video and tell y'all. But that woman, Miss Pat, she's can be deemed a threat to Miss Gina and Miss Dennis by saying she gonna slap her mama for her. Now, like I said, it could have been a joke. It was a very tasteless joke, and she needs to be definitely reprimanded for that, because it's a heated situation already from being on the show, that things are not transpiring how Portia wanted them to be. She tried to go back and do some more editing to make her look in a better light, to her succumbing to wanting to put paws or put hands on her former ex-lover, ex-boyfriend, ex-fiance, Dennis McKinley. She was finna fight him, cause I was trying to figure out who was trying to fight. And I had to go back and watch it again. And from what I'm seeing, Portia threw the first swing. And I'm like, is she crazy? Has Portia Williams really lost her mind? Because evidently, she had to fight. I don't know what kind of life she was living when she was younger, but she ain't got nothing but a fighting spirit in her. And that's not good. And that's not level-headed, because she's not handling her emotions appropriately. And one thing I do know, for a person that likes to fight all the time, they're going to find somebody who's going to lay them the hell out. And they're going to be in just cause for doing so, because they're going to be basically defending themselves from her. And then what's she going to do then? Cry, holler, foul, woe is me, I'm the victim here? No. Because you already painting a picture for what you want us to see who you are. And we're believing it now. We didn't want to believe. I didn't want to believe that you just this crazy and just dysfunctional. But after showing how you got down on your show, and you still want to put pause and you want to fight a man at that? Girl. But that's all I got for this video, guys. That's all I have for this video. I just want to know, why did Portia feel like she gave somebody else permission or condone the idea of putting hands on her daughter's grandmother? I don't understand that. I really don't. That's crazy. So I hope Dennis is taking notes, writing things down, recording them. Because all of this will help him in the court of law to definitely solidify himself, if not equal footing of sole parenting, or at least he, you know, has parental rights as well. And they have to split everything 50-50. Because of course she don't show her ass just too much, too far, too fast, too soon. And I'm done with her, really. I am done with her. But that's all I got, y'all, for this video. Y'all like it, love it, gotta have more. Get down in those comments. Y'all tell me what y'all think about Portia not defending her daughter's grandmother's honor. About, nah, baby, you can't put no pause. If anybody gonna put the pause, I'm gonna put the pause on. You know what I'm saying? She could say something like that, knowing that she probably would never do it, but she just know, I'm not finna let a stranger come and put no pause on her. You know, what do y'all think about Portia, you know, succumbing to the idea that she's allowing, or she's co-signing by not saying anything, another woman coming trying to fight her once was a mother-in-law, or soon to be mother-in-law, but really now she's just the grandparent of her child. What y'all think about that? Get down in them comments, because I'm kind of torn with Portia. Just keep getting worse every time I hear stuff. It's nothing new, it's nothing innovative, it's nothing positive. It's just negative. But that's all I got for this video, guys. Like it, love it, gotta help more. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and share my videos. You know, that helps me out over here. And get with the conversation. You know I like talking to y'all. I ain't gonna say we're gonna always agree. But I'm gonna always let you have your opinions. But don't come for me. You know what I'm saying? Don't do that. Because I have a free open space for everybody to say what they have to say. And for everybody to respect everybody's opinion. That's it. Because that's all we got over here. Like, we got assholes and mouths. We got, you know, opinions. But I'll see y'all next video. Y'all take care now. Bye.